Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Zero, and welcome to the Dark Side of Red Riding Hood, a game that's about walking down a path, sometimes diverting from that path, and walking down that path some more. Oh, and I think there's some murder going on or something. Little Red Riding Hood, listen well. Grandmother has fallen ill. Go visit her. Because the text box in the bomb told you to. But be careful of the wolf. He'll try to sell you on a very bad loan with high interest rates. Do not stray from the road. Because our insurance doesn't cover that. Gonna go to grandmother's house and listen to this song over and over again. Skills. Silent, no need to speak. I wonder if I'll see that rabbit save point. Yep, there you are, my friend. Gonna go to Red Riding Hood's grandmother's house. Gonna play this. Oh, the music changed. Now we could divert from the path, but I think we'll just keep going straight. So we can play this exciting gameplay. Going to grandmother's house. Screen number one. Screen number two. Just taking in the environment, you know. Got some chopped trees, some not chopped trees. Screen number three. Oh, it's darkening, or reddening actually. Screen number four. I can hardly contain my excitement. What awaits me at grandmother's house? Screen number five. And we finally made it. The riveting journey. All the hardships we had to experience to get to grandmother's house. All the payoff for this. The way the face is shadowed reminds me of the Helsing mangaka. Oh, Little Red Riding Hood, you've come all this way to see me. I am so happy. Don't question my suddenly deep voice. Congratulations, you beat the game. That's it. That's actually it. You just get to grandmother's house. And that's it. There's no epic conclusion. There's no wolf or anything going down. It's just, hey, we're gonna go grandmother's house. Okay. And then you go there. No diversions, no aliens, no demons popping up, no psychological terror. It's just another, like, normal walk through the forest to grandmother's house. And, you know, it's brilliant. Best game ever. Yeah, pretty much all the endings are just based on diverting from the route. I think there was a game that tried to do something like this called The Path. I've never played it, but I know it had some gimmick like that. Although you only get to the credits by going for the bad end, which is Charon's way of saying, oh, an ending where no one dies and everything's happy. That's horrible. That's completely boring. Let's slaughter everyone. Diverting through Route 1. Get to see some more trees, some more grass. Some more chopped down trees and, you know, logs, some nice rocks. Yep. Ooh, flowers. Some pretty flowers are growing here. I got some yellow flowers. I'm a flower murderer. Ignore the moments of the force. That's just the wind. The wind is trying to communicate with me. It's saying, how's your day? How's your grandma doing? That's good. Hey, can you pick me up at the airport? Coming in from town. Let's see if this sign changed. Some kind of horror siren. Running with about to axe people or something. She's gonna axe if she likes axe puns. If you learn anything, if you so much as divert from one route in your life, it will completely change your fate. For no inexplicable reason, you will murder your grandmother. If you so much as take a shortcut, so follow your GPS. Don't doubt it. Or this happens. Little Red Riding Hood, listen well. Grandmother has fallen ill. Go visit her. But be careful of the wolf. Do not stray from the road. Inside the basket are a wine bottle and an axe. Now hurry up and take out that old hag.
Red Riding Hood's mother put out a hit.
The big twist is Red Riding Hoods were like just their title given to these League of Assassins, like Assassin's Creed. You know, they wear the Red Riding Hoods and stuff, and you give them a little wine and a little basket of goodies, and this is like your target's like hidden in there. Requisit in pace. So this time we will go down route number 2. Let's see how our life changes. Looks a lot like route number 1. This forest really needs to get its act together. Like, redesign its infrastructure, because these paths are all the same. Like, they actually are all the same, I guess. Oh, no, this is different.
Somehow, I am stuck. Well, no. I am lost, apparently. Huh. I don't know what's with this forest that's moaning wind. Sure got dark out. I am lost, aren't I? Yep. I wonder how many loops I'm gonna have to do. Is there a way I can divert from the path, maybe? No, maybe. It's like the game said, yo, you like just walking through screens and paths? We'll have an unending one. The scariest thing of all. I feel like I'm missing something. Like there's some kind of secret path I have to find. Maybe. What does it seem to be? Alright, this is getting ridiculous. And then Red Riding Hood realized she should have invested into a GPS. Though Red Riding Hood kept walking, even after the sun had set, she was still going. She had become lost. Eventually, the hungry little Red Riding Hood looked inside her basket. But there was no food to be found within. The only things inside were a bunch of rocks. No one had ever seen Little Red Riding Hood again after that. Congratulations, you found the Get Lost Forever ending, and the Terrible Parent ending. So, path number 3. Where will it be this time? First we murdered Grandmother, then we got lost in the woods, because we're incapable of taking anything but the path we're assigned. Oh, the woodcutter? I wonder if it belongs to this person.
Good afternoon, Little Red Riding Hood. I'm a hunter. I consider the area around here my territory. Oh? Where are you going with that wine in your basket? Ah, a visit to your grandmother. What a brave girl you are, going all by yourself. And just where is your grandmother's house? In the forest, you say? I see. Thank you. Little Red Riding Hood, you've come all the way out here. Why not wander around for a bit and enjoy the scenery? Oh, but remember, a wolf lives in the forest, so be careful.
I will be careful, Black Silhouette Man. It's like we're going down the list of various atmospheric howling wind noises. I mean, if you go with the original story of Red Riding Hood and a lot of fairy tales, the wolf essentially is always representative of predators. Sometimes sexual predators, sometimes just
predator is like a bandit per se. But I wonder if this game is going with the former, which means the hunter, or anyone really could be the wolf. Oh no, we'll see. It'd be kind of dark if it didn't go that way, but considering we murdered grandmother in one ending. Grandmother, there's this weird looping noise and it's really annoying. Ah, shit. It's going that way, isn't it? She's dead, huh? Pity. I guess the wolf got her. What? You think I did it? The man with a gun? What a cheeky little girl you are. Don't look at me like that. Ah yes, you still don't know what it is I hunt, do you? I forgot to tell you. Oh boy, I'm out. Christ. There's like nothing redeeming about that ending whatsoever. Oh, the music started back up. Path number 4. Flowers this time. So far the same. It's about the third screen where it actually changes. Before that, it's pretty consistent. Hmm. Weird. Did I find someone's pot farm? It's gonna be the plot of the beach, isn't it? Why is there so much weed everywhere? Grandma, how have you been making your money? Alright, what is it this time? What would the weed symbolize? Grandmother, your game is excessively dark. Grandmother? Well, that seems normal so far. Oh, Little Red Riding Hood. You've come all this way to see me. I am so happy. Oh, what was that? My ears are rather big and cliché. Oh, the better to hear your cute little voice with, my dear. What? My eyes are quite large. The better to repeat the story and be the wolf, my little dear.
What now? My hands are big. Yes, I wouldn't be able to hug you without these big hands. You're still going. My mouth is big. You see, my dear. The better to eat you if... Ah, this little Red Riding Hood sure has some tasty meat. The last one didn't taste very good. Maybe she was expired. Last one? Oh, she probably means the grandmother. That girl is so considerate of her mother. I can't wait to see what kind of little Red Riding Hood she'll send next. All right, last path. There was something kind of weird in the last ending. So Little Red Riding Hood's being sent. So, they're implying they're sending multiple. It wasn't the wolf that was the grandmother, it was like a twist. Where the grandmother is just like some monster, and the Red Riding Hoods are just being sent to satisfy its hunger. Swans. Weird. Rain. Heavy rain. No relation to the mediocre game. I don't know how this game's gonna top the last one. Maybe it'll just be a kind of a nice ending this time. There's no like howling noise, it's just rain. Grandmother, I've died to you about 4 or 5 times now. Hopefully I get a good ending. Hey there, are you Little Red Riding Hood? You poor girl. You have no idea what's about to happen to you. You've been thrown away, kid. I paid your mother quite a bit of money, no lie. It was a legitimate transaction. This is the same as the Fern ending, you assholes. So that's it for The Dark Side of Red Riding Hood, a game that lives up to its title of just being kind of excessively dark, no sense whatsoever, and that's pretty much sums up this game. It's just, you know, Red Riding Hood, your life is going to be awful. How many awful endings can we give you? And these are the true ends. The bad end is the one where you just go and everything's fine, which I actually thought was kind of a cool ending, like non-ironically.
just because of its kind of nature, you know. It's kind of like the new secret ending of Far Cry 4, essentially. Anyway, so thank you all for watching me play The Dark Side of Red Riding Hood. I'll see you guys later. Take it easy.